This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, welcome back, Chef Andrea from the Thirsty Beaver. We've got a burger on the menu. No better cookout item, summertime item. Get out there, get grilling, and make this burger.
Yeah, absolutely. We are making our version of a Beaver Special Sauce. It's going to be a little bit spicy.
Okay. It's got a little kick to it.
It does.
Then.
It's a take on like a Thousand Island, but we're going to add some jalapenos and some Cajun to it. And,
okay.
Yeah.
Now, let's talk about all the ingredients. Can we start here with this giant burger patty?
We have 2 8-ounce certified Angus beef burger patties right here.
It's huge.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then what else do we need?
Sure. This is a brioche roll right there. We have some baby cucumbers here that we're going to turn into pickles.
Mm-hmm.
Dill, we have garlic, sugar, salt. Mustard seeds.
Those are all things that...
For the pickles.
Yeah,
yep.
Okay.
And then for our sauce, our beaver sauce, we're going to use mayonnaise, ketchup, mustard, chives, Cajun seasoning, and we're going to use bread and butter pickles for that.
Yum. Sounds delicious. And you mentioned, too, I know sometimes when you are pickling something, mm-hmm. it can be a lengthy process. You're bringing it down for
us. Right. If you ever did anything with your mom or your grandmother and they always had the mason jars and they're sterilizing them and mm-hmm. it was kind of like an all-day project, this is something where you can take, if you're growing cucumbers this summer and you have dill and things like that in your garden,
yep.
You can take them and then make these the day before you want them. And they'll last about a week or so in your fridge, but they're going to be delicious, so they're not even going to really last that long. So,
all right.
Yeah.
Sounds good. So we've got a couple different things that you can do at home. If you want this recipe, head on over to roadshow.com. For now, we're going to head back into the kitchen with Will and Andrea.
All right, you have no idea how happy I am. Andrea's here. Thirsty Beaver is the place. She just told me we're going to make pickles. I love pickles. Michaela loves pickles. We love them when they're in the jars. You can put them with everything. How are we going to do this?
So we're doing our quick pickle. And so in this pan here, we're going to add some vinegar.
All right. What kind of vinegar?
Just white distilled vinegar.
Okay.
We are going to add our sugar and salt.
Mm-hmm.
And then just whisk that so that it dissolves.
Got it. I can do that.
And then in a container. So again, you don't have to worry about sterilizing anything container-wise. So you're going to throw your cucumbers in there. We have some garlic that we've sliced.
This is really easy because when I hear someone say they're going to make pickles, I think you got to go through that whole process with the mason jars and everything else. This is easy.
Yeah, so we are going to throw some dill in there. We're going to throw some jalapenos. So as they sit for a little bit, it will make it a little bit spicier.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have some mustard seed.
Put that in, too?
That's
easy.
Yeah. So once that's dissolved...
Okay, yeah, I think it's looks pretty good.
Yeah, you would let it cool down, and then we'd add some cold water to it.
Okay.
And then this just goes right over our cucumbers.
And that's it?
Yeah, you put it in the fridge for 24 hours, and the next day you'll have cucumbers to eat, or pickles to eat.
That's simple.
Yeah, they last a little bit for you. I mean, they're a great snack to have, and they're something that... If you run out, you just do it again.
And you know what? These are the perfect size. These pickles are the perfect size, too. Well, that was simple and easy and something you can take to the beach with you while you're at it. All right, we're going to talk about the Thirsty Beaver. We're going to make some burgers. It's summertime. Beach food. Back to you. Andrea's here from the Thirsty Beaver. We got burgers with special beaver sauce on it. We got the burgers all ready to go.
We do.
You got some bacon?
Yeah.
I'm just staring at the bacon. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Bacon trans.
We're going to make our sauce right now. So
okay.
In the bowl, we have mayonnaise. And then we have some chopped bread and butter pickles.
Are all of these going
in
there?
All of them
okay.
are going in.
Good. I love pickles.
I love the bread and butter ones, too.
We have a whole jalapeno chopped up. That can go in.
Ooh.
We have Cajun seasoning.
This one here?
That
okay.
one right there.
All of what is placed here.
And then about a spoonful of mustard.
Any certain mustard in particular? Just regular?
Just regular
is it spicy?
Yellow mustard.
Okay.
And then we have ketchup.
A spoonful of that?
Yep. And we have some chopped chives.
Great.
And
it already smells so
you're
good.
You're going to squeeze some lemon into there.
Okay.
And then it's going to get mixed up.
Don't want to get any seeds.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And then I'll give
all
that
right.
a
So while
stir.
She's mixing that, yes. you can build your burger.
All right. So look at this. I mean, these buns are perfect. Put them on there.
Yeah.
Did you toast those up before?
A little bit. It is a buttered brioche roll, so they are. Mm-hmm. They're really good for the burger, especially the size of them. So they kind of
keep to that.
And then lettuce, tomato, some bacon.
Some lettuce on.
Now, while I'm stirring up this sauce here, is there a certain color that we should be looking for? Should I add more ketchup or?
It depends on if it's too spicy for you, you can always add more ketchup to it and mayonnaise, and it'll mellow it out a little bit. But the color, that kind of peachish color.
That's what we're going for?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
All right, looks good.
All right, cool. And then some of that can go on top.
There you go. Pass it down. That. Is this something that's currently on the menu?
We do have this running with a hot dog right now, the sauce. And we'll play with it a little bit more.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then some pickles that we made.
And these were really easy to make, too. Simple and easy to make.
Remind folks at home what flavors went into this.
We have
stuck in there.
Sugar, like salt, pickles. Garlic, dill, mustard seed, and some jalapeno.
Hello.
What was that? I think you said they're good.
That is what I said.
You're starting to sound like one of those minions.
I know. They're really good.
Awesome.
All right. Now let's take this on.
All right.
See how this is. And it's a big burger, too.
It is a big burger.
Yeah. All right.
And the burgers on the you got a lot of burgers on the menu.
We do. We try to run a few specials also, but we have about 7 different types right now that we're working with.
And topped with all different things?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, topped with all different things, yep.
Yum. You guys actually have 2 locations that we want to remind people at home about. Where are you located?
We are on Atwood Ave in Cranston, mm-hmm. and we are now in Smithfield at 45 Cedar Swamp Road.
Great.
Do I have stuff all over my face?
You're good now.
little tomato right here.
Right here?
There you go. Yep,
am
you
I
got
good?
It.
Okay.
Very
okay.
nice.
Oh, good. Thanks. No, it's really
gotta look out for one another.
Burger's great. I mean, you think summer, you want to make a good burger. Some people will, you know, they kind of skimp on the burgers. But having something like this is plenty. You know, it's a good-sized burger, tastes great, and the sauce that you put on top really adds to it.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Now, what you look for in a burger, I know a lot of times when it comes to meat, what's the percentage, what's the ratio that you're looking for? We see a lot of, 85-15.
Yeah, I mean, 85... it would be great. You want something with a little bit more fat into it so that you get that flavor out of it. If you stay towards the leaner side, it tends to be more dry on you. You want something with a little bit more fat.
And also, the other thing, too, is when people order a burger or cook a burger, you don't have to cook it till it's like leather sitting on there. Because, I mean, this here, I think, it may be a little too red for some people, but I think this, I mean, it tastes like a hamburger.
Right? Yeah, I mean, you want to go medium, rare, medium, you're going to get the juiciest out of it. I mean, if you don't want the blood, you're obviously more than welcome to go mid-well to well-done. But again, if you are going to go on the well-done side, you want to make sure that there's more fat content into the meat so that it
That's
stays
a good
juicy
tip
and flavorful.
Too, yeah.
Right.
All right, let's plate up another one.
Okay.
Because, Will, I'm sorry, you kind of messed up that plate. It's a little messy. All right, so here we go. Let's go over this again. We got the bun.
Here. We got buns.
Sure.
We'll put another burger on here.
We're like
professionals. This, some lettuce.
And is that bib lettuce?
That is bib lettuce.
Okay.
I like that, especially in a salad.
Put this here. Okay.
Okay.
I want to put some. You want bacon? We'll put bacon.
Do I want bacon? Is that a serious question?
Put some bacon
on here. You're probably just asking because you just want to eat more of
it. Okay. There you go.
All right.
Put that on there. We are rock and roll.
There we go. Awesome. All right. 2 burgers down. You can make these for your barbecue. If you want the recipe, head on over to roadshow.com.